are the beginning of our cables. I split the yarn on the previous, so I'll just kind of slide that back in. It's a very loosely twisted yarn, so it's easy to split and cause problems when you're trying to cable all over the place. Now that twist is starting to flatten out. So it's going to start to look a little more like it should and be easier to knit for the next couple of rows. Okay. So I picked up a split yarn as an extra stitch. So this is loose at the moment, but that will work itself out when I wash and block. Clearly have not had enough caffeine yet to deal with this. So it's time for a nice cup of Earl Grey or chai or something. Can somebody spare a cup of brains? All right, I think I found where things went awry. I had picked up an extra stitch here, but that was in the mistaken belief that I had caught the stitch that had pulled out here. So I had a drop stitch here. I picked up an extra. So I dropped the extra and repaired the drop. And who's on first, what's on second? But anyhow, we should be able to keep going. And I still need more tea. The cable on this pattern can be a little challenging simply because it's 8 stitches in total, so 4 stitches that are being crossed, and this is a super bulky yarn. So that does make for a very tight cross, which could lead you to say, forget it, I'm not doing it. And the thing to keep in mind for this pattern is you only do that cross 5 times out of the entire pattern. You're only going to cable 5 times. Not too bad for something that turns out awfully cute and, you know, is suitable for protests or any other cool weather. So something to keep in mind when you're wrestling with the first row going, it's only 5 times. And now that I've done one, I only have 4 more times to do the cable. And that is every 10th row. So 9 rows of normal, 1 gnarly cable, and then another 9 rows of normal. Rinse and repeat. Attention. time for row four again, the cable portion of the program. So here's a couple of cable needles. Of course, I just used a piece of wire before. I've also used chopsticks and pencils and other things. There's lots of styles. There's more than this out there, all kinds of styles. But all we're trying to do is hold the stitches so that we can cross them to the front or the back. So this is my personal preference. I get kind of manhandly when I'm knitting sometimes, and this way I can pick up my stitches and then let this hang, and then I know they're not going to fall off no matter how much I manhandle the work. And then I can either knit off of that needle or, you know, move the stitches back. I thought that I would like this one, but I don't. And I think only because it's so long. I mean, the lump part does allow, I don't know, your stitches to stay and not fall off. But yeah, I couldn't get into this one. And this one I actually tried, I think, as my first real cable needle. And I didn't like it because I am so manhandly that even with the little grooves, my stitches would come off of one end or the other. At this point, it's probably safe for me to use. I've been doing cables long enough, but yeah, it's just been sitting in the bag waiting for me to love it. Purl two, but I'm going to slip the first one so it gives a nice edge. Purl. And then it's time to do my little crisscross. So slip the next four stitches. Official cable needle. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next four stitches off. And hold them to the back. And I just let them hang. And then I go back in. Got my yarn wrapped around the back of my cable needle. That's not going to help me at all. Could I have tangled that up more?
What?
Sure, but I'm not sure how.